I'm Brigantia, Blackbird of Blackbird's Brew. Happy Wednesday and welcome back to our series on the Havamal. This week we are looking at verse 37 and of course beginning, as we always do, by examining three different translations. The first translation reads, "One's own house is best, though small it may be. Each man is master at home. With a bleeding heart will he beg who must his meat at every meal." That's by Olive Bray. Second translation, "Better a house, though a hut it be, a man is master at home. His heart is bleeding, who needs must beg when food he fain would have." And that's the Bellows translation. And now for the last. "It doesn't matter where you live as long as you have a place. Better to call a place home, or you'll feel worse and worse as you beg for more and more." That comes from The Cowboy Havamal by Dr. Jackson Crawford. So the point of this is that it's better to have a humble home than no home at all. This is strong counsel not to judge the value of our home by its size or its expense. The true value of a home is its ability to shelter and protect us, a place for us to be and have things all of our own. Living in modest circumstances isn't a cause for shame or a sign that one has failed in life. If anything, it makes it far more easy to live within our means. Moreover, a small home doesn't mean that it can't be charming or cater to the personality of its residents or be lacking in beauty in any way. The way we take care of it and the way we present it matters far more than its size. If we treat our home with respect, it is respectable. To be without a settled home and just drifting from place to place is to be a beggar, or to be as a beggar, and having to rely on emotional manipulation to have our most basic needs met. And it isn't good to exist in that fashion. For an adult to not be able to take care of themselves and provide for themselves, it is a source of personal shame. How can you have any kind of self-respect if the only way you can live is by making yourself an object of pity and having to rely on others? It's much better to have a place of your own, even in the humblest of circumstances, and to be able to have at least that much without having to impose on people as a lifestyle. So those are my thoughts on this particular verse. Now's the time to let me know what you think and what you get out of this verse. Tell me all about it in the comments below, or better yet, join us on Gilded. If you go to this description box on this video, there's a link to join Blackbird's Brew. You're very welcome among us. We have a wide range of channels on a variety of pagan and witchcraft related topics, so you're welcome to explore, indulge, and of course add content of your own, and hopefully also get acquainted with the other members. And because it is all about forming community. Blackbird's Brew isn't just a place to dump information. It's a place to have actual conversations, pick other people's brains, and just kind of reason on all of the pagan ideas that we have in our heads. So hopefully you will come join us soon. But in the meantime, that'll do it for this video, and I will see you in the next one. Bye.